let's have a look at the mechanism for chlorine reacting with methane to see them in action. First, the covalent bond in a chlorine molecule has to break homolytically, and the energy needed is provided by ultraviolet light. Each chlorine atom gets an unpaired electron and two chlorine radicals are produced. This is the initiation step. We are creating radicals from a non-radical molecule. A chlorine radical can now react with methane and will form hydrogen chloride, a non-radical. This will leave an unpaired electron on a CH3 group, making what is called a methyl radical. The methyl radical can then react with chlorine molecules, Cl2, to form chloromethane, a non-radical. And a chlorine radical is produced as well. These are both propagation reactions, as a radical species has reacted with a non-radical species to form a new radical. Finally, the two radical species can combine together to form a stable non-radical molecule in a termination step. There are several possibilities for this. Two chlorine radicals can combine together to reform a chlorine molecule, Cl2. A chlorine radical and a methyl radical can combine together to form a chloromethane molecule, CH3Cl. And finally, two methyl radicals can combine together to form ethane, CH3CH3. For chloromethane, a chlorine group has been substituted for a hydrogen in the original methane, making this a substitution reaction. As a free radical started the reaction, it is described as free radical substitution.